Cake Masters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35 and with free UK P&P. To order your 12-month subscription, either visit creatingcraft.tv or call 09056 480 480 and quote the item number on your screen.
Feel inspired. Hello and a very warm welcome. It is our fourth ever in the series of the Cake Academy shows from us here at Creating Craft. Great to have your company. Every show so far has been amazing. This show is going to be equally as amazing, I know. You saw there pictures of cakes inspired and designed by Liz Marek, who's our special guest today. More on Liz in a second. She's just travelled all the way over from the Birmingham NEC at the Cake International Show to be with us live here today on Creating Craft. Now, if you are watching us for the very first time, I know lots of our cake demonstrators have been on the social networks saying tune in to Creating Craft at 5 o'clock. I'm Dave Bradford, and this is a show dedicated to, well, inspire you, to tutor you, to give you the knowledge and the know-how to get amazing designs from your cake making and your cake decorating. That is what it's all about. Now, it may well be that during the show you might want to buy something from what we're going to be demonstrating. That's absolutely fine if you do want to do that. What you'll find is we have what we call an L, which is just here. Now, that gives you the details of what Liz or myself are going to be using during the show at any one time. Now, the most important thing is that there. That's the item number. So if you like the look of something, whether it's a sugar paste or a tool or a mat or something, make sure you either give us a call on the phone number, which is just down there on the bottom of the screen, or you can equally go to our website and order that way as well. Even if you're a brand new customer, www.creatingcraft.tv is there. And actually, talking of the website, while you're there, have a little look at the Cake Academy section. You can, if you've missed the first three shows, you can actually watch them back with our guests previously, Rosie Cake Diva, Christina Ludlam, her show from a couple of weeks ago is there, Cassie Brown, who was with us last week, and also you'll be able to watch this one back at a later date as well after we've done the show, of course, with Liz. So it's all there at the Cake Academy section at creatingcraft.tv, the website. So that's all the kind of facts and figures. Let's, without further ado, introduce you to our cake superstar this week, lovely Liz Marek. Hello, Liz.
Hello.
Good to see you. Welcome to Creating Craft.
Thank you so much.
Did you enjoy the NEC?
Oh, it was wonderful. So many beautiful cakes. It was absolutely mind-boggling. The talent is out of control.
I was in the hall next door, but then I came across to see the Cake International show, and it looked incredible.
It was amazing. And they told me that they weren't that great this year. It was like,
what?
I know.
Really?
So I was like, wow, I'd like to see what's great.
Well, thanks for coming over from Birmingham and making it to the show. Tell us a bit about yourself, because you have made cakes for some quite well-known people, haven't you? Jay Leno?
Yeah. I'm mostly known for doing novelty-type cakes. I actually won a Cake Masters Award for Best Novelty Cakes last night.
Oh, so fantastic.
I'm a little tired, you know why. But I'm known for making, you know, figures and for celebrities and things who are celebrating big, you know, events and things, because that's what cake's for, right?
Absolutely.
Big events.
and Liz, you live in America, yeah?
I sure do.
So we're lucky to have you here, so
yeah.
Thank you for being
here. Oh, thanks for having me.
Right. Now, what are we talking about today? We're doing vintage, aren't we?
We are. Vintage is an extremely popular design all over the world. It's one of those things that brides are always wanting. They're also great for birthdays. You can tone it, you can, you know, play it down, keep it simple, or you can make it go all the way over the top. And, you know, something for me, and I think most cake decorators, is you want something that's going to make your life easier, but still look amazing and fantastic. So that's what we're going to be talking about today.
Okay, now hopefully you've got us on your TV, or if you're watching us on your tablet, that's fine as well, or on your mobile. But if you have a little look at the website at any point, there's actually a Cake Academy section, which is totally dedicated to cake decorating and cake making. Here it is. This is what you'll be looking out for if you go to creatingcraft.tv. Also, as well as that, we are the only place in the United Kingdom, actually, that stocks every single Wilton product. So if you're a Wilton fan, or you've been trying to get hold of something from Wilton and you've gone to a supplier or a retailer and it's not had exactly what you've been wanting, every single product that Wilton produce is in our inventory and it's on our website. There's a special Wilton section as well. So with any place in the UK that actually brings you everything that Wilton manufactures, which is amazing.
It's like cake heaven.
It is. Cake heaven on your screen.
Yes. Don't tell them that. That's just too much temptation.
And if you have a little look at some of the cakes in front of us as well, these are some of the cakes that Liz has been working on. Mm-hmm. They are amazing.
And they flew on a plane.
Did they really?
Yeah, they really, in a box.
And they arrived in one piece?
Well, you know, you don't look at the backs. No, they're good.
No excess baggage?
No.
Wow,
nah.
I'm impressed.
Yeah, thank you.
Well, by the way, one thing else that I've not mentioned, if you were a Sky viewer, you have the ability and the service of series record. So if you'd like to do that, you can actually series link and just basically select that on the menu and automatically your Skybox will then record every single episode and indeed any other episode that's kind of related to this as well. So it will record every single show on Sundays at 5 o'clock and then any show during the week that's kind of related to the Cake Academy will also be recorded too. So you can actually series link if you're a Sky viewer. Right, brilliant. Now, I spot cake lace. I spot quite a few things that I recognize.
Yeah, some of these are my favorite things that I use, and I'm actually a huge fan of molds. There's so many different kinds of molds, and Wilton makes some really great, fantastic molds. And the thing about molds is you can use them for different things. So, you know, today I might be using a pearl mold to be making a nice border around the cake, but I also could be, using it to make other types of designs for fashion or just for nice decorative element around the bottom.
I'm quite surprised. All the cake experts, yourself included, that I've met, I've actually been very pro molds. I thought you'd been anti-molds, like it's a bit of a cheat.
Only for competitions, you know? When it comes to producing a cake for clients and things, you know, everybody has champagne tastes on beer budgets. And so you want to give your clients exactly what they want. And, you know, they don't care if it's made from a mold. They just want it to look beautiful. They want it to look unique.
Well, I suppose they don't need to know, do they?
No, they don't, you know. And you know what? Often clients will see a picture on Pinterest or they'll see a picture online somewhere and they'll say, hey, you know, how do I make this cake or how can you make this cake for me? So you want to actually replicate that exact same thing, and where if somebody's piped it freehand, it's a little bit, you never know what you're going
to get. Absolutely. Well, I noticed we've got some molds here in front of us, and in particular the pearl mold. Mm-hmm. This is a Katie Sue design mold, isn't it?
That's right. And this is a great mold. This one actually has this is like more of like a jewelry type mold, but they make a pearl ones, they make brooch ones, all kinds of different designs. But you can wrap it around the bottom of a cake. Like this, and just brush it with a little bit of gold dust or something, and it goes quite fast. Can you imagine rolling each one of those little balls and trying to get them all the right size? I know about you.
Never.
No, it's not going to happen. And I do this for a living, so I don't know about you.
Now, would you paint that when it's on the cake, or would you paint that before it gets put on?
I would do it after it goes on the cake, okay. Yeah. So when you're using gold, though, you want to make sure that you're using a dark-colored sugar paste, then you put the gold on top. But if you're going to do a pearl, you would use white.
Okay, so pearl will be white, but any other, when you say dark, what sort of color would you recommend?
Like a dark brown or a black.
Okay.
Yeah, and then if you can see here, I actually didn't cover the entire surface with the gold, so that gives it the vintage look. When you can see those little bits of the brown and the black showing through, that makes you think of like a vintage mirror or, a frame or something, or has those little dark bits in between. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of nice for you because you don't have to be too careful.
Totally.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. So I'm going to show you how to use this mold. It's very easy.
Now, we have got Renshaw sugar paste in the show as well. I know many of you will be perhaps on your way back right now from the Cake International show in Birmingham, so many of you may be watching this as a repeated show. Either way, all of what we're showing you is in stock on our website if you'd like to, or you can phone us, of course, as well, if you'd rather do that.
So people do this in different ways. I'm just going to show you the way that I do it. Some people, they lay the fondant or the sugar paste. Sorry, in America, we call it fondant or gum paste. So sugar paste, if you roll this into here and you could cut off the excess with a knife, but I actually just dust the surface with some corn flour or some icing sugar, you call it, called powdered sugar, and roll this into a nice long...
What's a typical week in Liz's life then? Do you spend most of your time traveling to shows like we've had in Birmingham, or are you normally in one place? Or?
Oh, no, I'm always moving around. It seems like we're always headed to new shows, and I really like to compete. So I'm a little bit of a competition junkie, and I think I'm going to do Cake International next year.
Are you?
Yeah, well, these cakes made it.
Absolutely. Why not?
So, I like to travel around and... compete and teach as well. Mm-hmm. And I actually do a lot of it online, though. So most of the time we're in a studio just kind of like this, mm-hmm. except for a lot less people.
Well, it's great you've actually got at home today, you know, like a free tutorial with Liz. So
yeah.
If you want to email in and interact with the show, if you'd like to say hello, we'd love to hear from you. We are live at 10 past 5 on Sunday. Obviously, if you're watching us at a different time, it's a recording. But say hello to Liz and myself, studio@creatingcraft.tv. Any questions? Maybe something's gone wrong, you didn't know what you did wrong, want some answers and some advice. That's what Liz is here for. So
after you press it in there, you just give it a flip.
Yep.
And you just remove it just like that. And because this is the Renshaw sugar paste, which is a little bit stiffer than the fondant, the mm-hmm. rolling icing, then you can pick it up and move it around really easily. You can attach it to your cake, and then you can paint it however you like. You could even paint the outside gold and leave the inside white and give it a little pearl. So that's real easy to use. And that saves you a lot of time from having to hand roll all those little bits and pieces.
Mm-hmm. And just look how impressive that is. Mm-hmm. Accuracy every single time. As Liz said, to actually roll those little balls out at the same size by hand would be a nightmare. You'd never be able to do
that. That's what the thing of nightmares is made for cake decorators. Yes. I was rolling these balls over and over again and just never ended. So some of the other molds that we have here is this brooch mold. And so this is actually the first time I use this mold. And I just loved it. I thought, wow, I'm keeping this. This is great. This is awesome. Because you can just press your fondant in just like we did, or your sugar paste.
In two different colors.
So you've got different colors.
One color for the frame and another color for the actual cameo in the middle of it. Isn't that lovely? I mean, that could go on the top of a cupcake. You could have lots of them around the side of the cake.
You can paint the outside with a little bit of gold. You can pearlize it. You can make it look really ornate. You can use different colors of dusting or painting, and I just think it looks fantastic. You can pair this up with the pearl mold and make necklaces around cakes. It's just fantastic. Very iconic of a vintage look is the brooch, so that's a really awesome element there.
So all these molds that we're talking about during the show, you'll find those on the website as well, creatingcraft.tv.
So this is a similar, process here. You just take a little bit of your fondant or your sugar paste, and you press it in.
Mm-hmm.
And again, I don't cut away the excess. I think it tends to kind of make the situation a little bit stickier than it needs to be. Give it a press. Make sure it goes into all those little details.
Mm-hmm.
Just flip it over. Pop it out.
Now, the Renshaw sugar paste is the ready-to-roll icing, okay? So that's what's on the screen right now. So sugar paste is the ready-to-roll icing. 250 grams is on the screen right now for you.
And then take a little bit of the white and do the same thing. And I just love the accuracy that you can get. I mean, if I had to make 50 of these cupcake toppers, I could just sit here and just do one after the other, watch my favorite show.
Mm-hmm.
Don't even have to think about it that much. Just pop them out. And then you can use a little bit of this edible glue, which is a lot better for attaching edible details, because water tends to be real slippy.
Sure.
So it activates the sugar in the fondant, and it won't stick, and they just go all over the place.
Now, we're very well aware that obviously we've got a brand new group of viewers that are finding this channel and finding this particular show for the very first time. Now, if you are thinking about going for the Renshaw sugar paste, which we were talking about, which is the ready-to-roll icing, they are available in different colour options, but they're all under the same item number, which is just there on the screen. So that means that you only pay one postage charge. So if you're thinking, okay, it's going to be $2.99 for each one I order, that's going to push the price right up. No, it's $2.99 for the item number. So if you want, I don't know, 6 or 7 packs of this, you'll only pay one P&P of £2.99. And they're £1.61 if you're in the Crate and Craft Club, or £1.79 if you're not. All those colours are in stock and are available at our website, crateandcraft.com. So if you wanted all of those colours there, all of them, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 19 of them there, or 18 of them there, 18 options, you'd only pay one P&P of $2.99. So a good way of ordering and saving money.
Fantastic deal, yeah. I can never have too many color options, because, when you go to add the color in afterwards, it makes it real soft, makes it real gooey, especially if you need a nice, dark, rich color. I know they have like a dark red, which is almost impossible to do yourself. So that's really fabulous.
Now, also, when you've actually opened up the modeling paste or the ready-to-roll icing, do you have to seal it very carefully so that it doesn't dry out? Or?
Yeah. This is made to be, drying and stuff, so you can handle it. So you want to always have like a piece of plastic on hand and keep it wrapped up and away from the air.
Mm-hmm.
You can also take a little bit of vegetable oil. I think it's called, or vegetable shortening, it's called Trex here.
Yes.
And you just rub that on your fingers, and that keeps the surface a little bit, it's almost like lotion for fondant,
mm-hmm.
and it keeps it from drying out a little bit.
So once you've opened it, you don't have to use it straight away. You can make it last a little
Absolutely,
while.
Absolutely, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, and so, you know, actually, people have asked me if I mess, if I cover a cake with the a fondant and I mess it up, do I toss it in the trash? And that you can absolutely just roll it back up, reuse your scraps, put them in a sealed bag, you know, and you don't have to put it in the fridge or anything. You just put it in a cupboard and use it when you need it, and it's fresh, fresh as a daisy.
Superb. Well, look at the results you get. And this was a Katie Sue mold. This one, I believe, wasn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. And there's so many options for those.
And also the bow that we showed you, that was actually a Karen Davis mold. Mm-hmm. We'll do the cameo first of all, though, for you. There it is, if you'd like to go for the cameo mold. Obviously, this is still fairly flexible because it's still, it's not dried yet completely. But look at the detail in the frame, and also look at the detail in the actual figure itself as well. Beautiful. Mm-hmm. And then the bow that you did, that was from the Karen Davis collection.
Yes, as well. There's many different shapes and sizes.
She's joining us next week.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah, on the cake and cutlery.
I miss her.
Next Sunday at 5 with a Christmas theme, so that's going to be special.
I'll have to watch that one.
Absolutely. There you go, look, so there's that lovely bow from that mould, and that mould is also on the screen now for you if you'd like to pop it into your order. And bows, to be honest with you, will look great on any celebration cake, won't they?
Yeah, and you know what, I like to use bows as accent pieces to kind of tie in, like if you're going to do a cake and cupcake toppers, I would go ahead and roll out all of my cupcake toppers, like I have some here, and then I would put some texture on top, and you can add bows or brooches or as accent pieces, and it goes really fast.
Are we able to maybe cover something with the gold that we were talking about? Well, have we got any of that available?
No, I don't have the gold dust. But you can use any kind of like, there's like a Wilton dust, there's a gold kind. You just mix it with a little bit of alcohol, and you dust it around the edges of the brooch, and it gives that real nice shine.
Okay, so we've done all that demonstration. So let's just remind you then of what we've been using. Let's have a little look. We've got a little shopping list for you if you want to go for possibly the pearl border. Here that comes. So this is, remember, from Katie Sue. So you've got the two different types and sizes of the pearls on that particular mould as well. We've got the beaded and the rimmed as well, or the shadow to choose from. But you do get, of course, one that's got both of them side by side. So that's 336023, £11.69. The bow from Karen Davis, remember, and she's going to be with us next week on the show from 5 o'clock. There that is, if you'd like to go for that one. That's a big, big mold, actually. You've got large bows and every other size that you could ever possibly wish for in that one mold, and that's on the screen now. The cameo, that was from Katie Sue as well, Katie Sue Designs. And the cameo is actually separate to the frame, so if you don't always want to have the figure in the middle of it, that's a really good mold to consider going for as well. And then we've also got the edible glue. Now, all these little accessories that you need as a cake decorator or a cake maker, you'll find them on the website createandcraft.tv. This is the 12-pack, the pink tip sugar roses, pink metallic draggies, and also the edible glue as well. All of that for just £12.99. So that's the shopping list for that particular demo that we showed you. What's on your sleeve next then, Liz?
So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to make a couple of these cupcake toppers and using some of these things that we've created.
Okay, fantastic.
So taking it to the next level. I'm actually going to be using some of the modeling tools here. These are some great beginner modeling tools. This is actually what I used when I first started cake decorating. I got them from a, you know, Wilton. And there's, you know, various size things that you can use, but depending on what you want to do. But I'm going to just use this little... I don't remember what it's called. I'll use this one.
Now you'll find that we've got the cake decorating tools available in the show as well, and also on the section on our website about Wilton, you'll find the cake decorating tools. They're not very expensive at all. They're very, very affordable, and they'll last you a lifetime probably.
Yeah, I still have the same ones, and you get very attached to the certain ones.
So there we go. If you'd like that, it's on the screen right now.
So I'm going to use this tool over the top of some of the Renshaw fondant, ready to roll icing, with a piece of plastic wrap over it. And I'm going to use my tool to create some lines here. And we're basically creating like a tufted look, which is this right here. And the reason why you put the plastic wrap over the top is it keeps the top moist, so it doesn't dry out. So you can use, you can do a bunch of them at a time, an assembly line.
Good top tip.
And then you can this keeps the tool from digging in to the fondant and keeps it nice and smooth. So you get your lines on there, and you have this right here, and then you go ahead and use your edible glue. This stuff is just fantastic for gluing down these little jar jays.
Does it have any flavor or not?
No, it's flavorless. Right. It's better than using, you know, water or anything like that, because it just is instantly kind of perfectly tacky.
And if you look at the topper just here for a minute, it's got a lovely kind of quilted effect.
Yeah.
And you put the glue obviously where the intersection is, and then just add the bead.
You take your little jar jay These things can be a nightmare to get.
You call them dragees. I said draggies.
Yeah, I didn't point it out. I didn't want to embarrass you. You know, so you can just take those.
Sorry, I'm not posh enough.
But you could take one of the molds and you could just place that over the top.
Right.
Or you could take one of the brooches and put that over there and alternate them. But they all go together and they all look nice. And then you could take the same effect and put it on top of a cake and use the brooch as an accent piece and the dragees. On the quilting effect on the actual cake itself.
Now the thing is, once you've got these tools, you know, sky's the limit. You can create so many different effects and so many different techniques with them. And it's a one-off investment. Once you've got them, you've got them. They're never going to run out or wear out.
Yeah, yeah. And you know, a great way to organize your molds is to get like a binder with some plastic inserts, and then you can just put the molds into the binder, and then you can just flip through them when you're looking for certain molds and things. And then that way they don't just all end up in a bin in your kitchen drawer.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Where did you start? When you became a cake decorator, how did it all start for you? Was it a hobby that became a business? Or?
Yeah, I think that's how a lot of cake decorators get started out, is they think, oh, this will be fun. And I actually used it as sort of a stress relief, which is so funny because cake decorating is not relaxing. It's very stressful. It can be at times, you know. It's a lot of pressure. Somebody's wedding cake, that's very important,
you know.
You want to deliver. And so, but what's really, really satisfying is delivering a cake to somebody and they just love it. They give you, you know, they give so much love to you and you get addicted to that feeling.
Just look at all of these fantastic cakes that Liz has made over the years. It's incredible. It really, really is. And you've made cakes for Jay Leno,
yep.
Tom Cruise, had lots of celebrity commissions.
Yeah.
And it's great that she's here today, Liz, to share her hints and tips. Now, it's all about vintage today. So we've got the cameo going on. We've got the quilting, of course, as well. And the dragees, I now know that.
Mm-hmm. Good job.
To kind of finish it off.
You're Brilliant. On your way.
Okay, so let's give you details of them. What do you want to do next, Liz?
So I was just going to finish off this cupcake here. You put the topper on top of your nice little cupcake. And I just have these liners here. And these are just lovely. This is such a delicate looking lace kind of cutout design. I actually didn't know these existed. Another one of those things I thought was awesome. And the way that you put these together is the little part with the flap
mm-hmm.
goes around the top and just tucks down into there. So that way it holds itself together. And then you can just pop your cupcake right in there. And then on a stand, you can just, you know, these look lovely.
So is that edible?
No, this is just a paper.
That's a paper. Okay.
Yeah, it's
so
a paper.
You can actually get molds as well that are kind of cupcake wraps, aren't they? You could make that out of sugar paste as well if you wanted to.
You could. If you wanted to use some of these molds and put them around your cupcake liners, you absolutely could. But you just have to remember that people are holding that and you have to, you know, set it up on a cake stand. So that's why they make these really pretty, like, cupcake liners to sort of dress up your just kind of blah cupcake liner that it was baked in.
Superb. So cupcakes still have a very, very popular place. I mean, I know lots of people that have had weddings and they've had cupcakes as individual wedding cakes. So possibly something as elegant and sophisticated as this is the sort of thing to consider if you are.
Absolutely. Oh, I make loads of wedding cakes that are just maybe one or two tiers, mm-hmm. but they have 200 guests, and they don't really, it takes a long time to cut 200 servings, so they
sure.
really prefer to just have the wedding cake for the bride and groom, and they just, you know, do their little cutting ceremony, and everybody has their cupcake waiting for them in front of them on the table. I mean, doesn't that sound lovely to
you? Oh,
totally,
absolutely.
Yeah, and it looks like this, not a little slice.
And so. Also, if you're full after the main meal or something like that, you can take it home with you.
Absolutely.
Too,
it's kind of like a gift and a dessert at the same time.
Before we see our next technique, I just want to remind you that if you are interested in the Cake Master magazines, we've actually got a very, very good offer on at the moment for 3 back issues. To be honest with you, what issue they are doesn't really matter because they're all full of practical hints and tips, each and every one of them. 3 back issues for just £5. So that's something that you may well want to consider if you're wanting to have something that you can leaf through to give yourself inspiration as well. Back issues, normally they would be about £3.70 each. So to get 3 of them for £5 is a great deal. That's on the website and also on the phones as well if you're interested in that today from
Absolute
Cake Masters.
Favorite cake magazine.
Really?
Yeah, it always has really like modern techniques too. You know?
Good.
Yeah, it's really great.
Superb. Mm-hmm. Okay, now still staying with cupcakes mm-hmm. and toppers.
One more design here.
Mm-hmm.
Another great thing to use is a stencil. I'm not a great piper. I'm not real good with royal icing. My thing is fondant. So, you know, molds and stencils really make things go quickly.
Mm-hmm.
So again, you can start with your round and I'm going to see if you want to try this.
It's
so
go
easy. I promise. We've got a little bit of royal icing here. We just got it wrapped up so that it doesn't get scaly on the top.
Mm-hmm.
And that Wilton tool set that we were talking about earlier comes with a little perfectly sized spatula. So I'm going to do one and show you.
Okay.
You just
remember, everything that Wilton make is on our website, on their shop on our website. So that's great.
You just take a small amount and you just spread that on there. And people always think they need to go real thick or they need to be real delicate, just press down and then scrape off the excess.
Now this is a damask template that we've got here, isn't it?
Yeah, and then you just pull it off. And
you wow.
Isn't that beautiful?
Look at
and
that.
And it's super simple. And people get really intimidated by royal icing and they think that it's going to be really scary.
But if people didn't know, they'd have thought that you'd have possibly done this freehand.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And they get really, really impressed. And you know what? Damask is a super, super popular design.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So are you ready? Are you nervous?
Okay. No. Okay. Not at all. So not with you as a teacher.
All right. So just a little
Does
bit
it matter
on,
which side
on
you
the
use?
Yeah, on the bottom side.
On the bottom side.
Yeah. So, of course, you went to the top.
Of course. That's me.
Okay. And you just put it on there and just spread it on. Don't be afraid to push a little bit firm.
Mm-hmm.
Push it all down there into the little crevices. And then now scrape off your excess. Just like you're doing plaster. You've done that, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, that just like that.
Okay.
All right, scrape that off. And put that back in the bowl.
Yep.
And then just peel off the top there and you have... And then suddenly you're hired as a cake decorator.
Oh, wow. I've got a new career. There we go.
Good job.
I feel like I'm a decorator, a cake decorator, because I do the show every week at 5 o'clock.
See that feeling you have right now? That's why people become cake decorators.
Exactly.
I did that.
Superb. So that's another top technique. And again, if you want the damask template here, which, of course, is wipe cleanable as well.
Oh, yeah.
Details are on the screen there for that. Very small outlay, but imagine the compliments you're going to get from people when you're using this on the top of not just cupcakes, but any type of cake. So it's only £4.49 if you're in the Crate and Craft Club, or £4.99 if you aren't in the club. And if you're wondering about joining, if you're watching this maybe for the very first time, you think, is it worth my while going to become a member of the Crate and Craft Club? If you're going to be buying cake decorations and moulds and sugar paste and Wilton things and all that sort of thing from us on a regular basis, yes, join. Because it's £20 to join, you get a £10 credit straight back on your account, so it's only £10 to join, and you get 10% at least of everything you buy for a whole year. Now, this is what Liz has been using. So there's the template, obviously. The Wilton toolkit, though, is here as well, and that's a 10-piece fondant and gum paste toolkit, complete with the holder to keep it all in, but very inexpensive when you consider they'll last you probably a lifetime, including that spatula as well. It's £32.39, complete with, of course, the holder to keep everything neat and tidy. And we've also got the cupcake wraps as well. Here they come. Now, these are the lace dahlia cupcake wraps in white. Non-edible, these, but it's a twin pack of those, and they are £8.09 if you're in the Crate and Craft Club. 358094. Okay, we are the Cake Academy. I'm Dave Bradford. This is the lovely Liz, of course, Liz Marek, who's normally in America, but she's over here for the International Cake Show, which is the last day today. And you came away from there early to be with us, so we're really grateful.
I know, it was tough.
You won an award last night. You won a prize.
I did. I won for Best Novelty Cakes.
Yeah. And what was the theme of it?
It was overall novelty cakes.
Oh, overall?
So, yeah. Wow. So, and I was up against some really, really amazing competition. So it was an extreme honor. And it's, you know, from your peers. So it's great. It's wonderful.
Brilliant. Well, she's with us today for the next half an hour or so. So again, any questions you may have, or you just want to say hello, email in studio@createandcraft.tv. Love to hear from you. And don't forget, of course, if you are a Sky viewer, series link all these programs every Sunday at 5 o'clock. Your box will automatically record the show and any other shows that are related to cake decorating during the week on Create and Craft as well. Because this is going to be and is your one-stop shop for cake decorating every Sunday, this hour dedicated to just the best techniques, the best tips, the best products, so you get the best out of your cake decorating. And seeing the sheer numbers of people that were at the show over the last few days, it's
mind-boggling.
Massively popular.
Yeah. Who knew cake was that popular?
I know.
Oh wait, yeah.
Now, also Virgin have a series link as well, not just Sky. So you can do that as well if you've got a Virgin box. That was Karen who emailed in and said that you can do that. Karen from Essex, so thank you for that. Okay, what next, Liz?
All right, so I'm going to show you this last mold. This is another Karen Davies mold, but this is a lace mold here.
Mm-hmm.
And it has a slot here where you can color the ribbon so that it's separated from the lace and make a two-tone, or you can actually lay fondant down first, or sugar paste, and then basically two colors. So I'm going to show you that real quick here.
Okay, lovely.
So, you know, ribbon and lace is another one of those things. It's extremely popular in a vintage design.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just going to... It's a little bit sticky in here.
Now, remember, you don't always have to use the entire mold if you don't want to. You can use just a part of it if you choose.
Yeah.
I like your idea, though, of using different colors in the molds.
Yeah, so you can just take a little bit of one color. This might be a little bit dried out on the end here because I didn't cover it and follow my own advice. Then you take some of the white. give it, you always want to condition your sugar paste.
What does that mean?
So that means when you first break it off, it might seem like a little bit rough or crumbly, and you might think that there's something wrong with it, but that's mm-hmm. how all sugar paste is. So you take off your piece, and you always want to give it a little knead with your hands, maybe a little bit of corn flour, and it basically just kind of gets it ready to go into a mold or go over a cake or something.
Okay.
And if you're having some tearing or sticking, you might want to just condition it once again until it feels like the right consistency.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to roll that in a little bit of the powdered sugar there, press it into our mold.
And the corn flour just means that basically the actual sugar paste comes out of the mold that much easier.
Yeah, everything, you know, edible has a certain amount of moisture in it. So you just want to kind of create a barrier between the mold and your paste so that it pops out. And if you're in a real humid area, you might want to put it into the refrigerator mm-hmm. or the freezer for just a couple moments. But you can see this comes out super easy. You just press that on to make sure it's nice and attached.
Now remember, this is a Karen Davis mold. It's on the screen now for you. And Karen is going to be our special guest next Sunday mm-hmm. on Cake Academy at 5 o'clock. So she will be here with us next week. But look at that. How mm-hmm. effective is that? Just
so
adding
much
a little
detail.
Bit of different yeah. color.
And you could even go over this with a little bit of pearl dust or something to bring out sort of this extra detail. And you could use a cutter and put this over the top of cupcake toppers, or you can put this around like a base all the way around the bottom and create a nice lace border around the base mm-hmm. and looks very, very nice and looks very detailed. Like, spent a lot of time on it.
It does look good.
Yeah.
It looks very, very good. So, mm-hmm. yeah, and the actual mold itself is probably about 10 inches long, something like that. So you can do
yeah.
quite a large area of the cake in
and
one
it,
go.
And it's seamless, really, mm. you know. So the way that it's made is that it lines up perfectly with itself. So, when it, you know, it's not going to look funky where it attaches together.
Now, the actual size of that, 21 centimeters. By 14 by 4. Okay, so that's the actual depth of it, the 4 mil. So that's that. If you'd like to go for that Katie Sue, no, it's not. It's Karen Davis, isn't it? Sorry, Karen Davis mold. Then it's $14.99 or $13.49 if you're in the Crate and Craft Club. Now, flowers. Something mm-hmm. that always looks great on decorated cakes is flowers, whether it's a cupcake or whether it's a larger cake or whatever.
Yeah, these are some pre-made flowers that another thing that I really, really love. They come in this little container here so that it keeps them all protected so they don't break or, you know, anything like that. You know, sugar flowers can be very delicate, but this is actual gum paste. They're mm-hmm. real sugar flowers. It's not like a pressed icing or anything like that. And these make great accents where you can put them on top of your cupcake liners with maybe a pearl border around the outside. You can use them on the edge of a cake like so. You mm-hmm. can put them in between where the seams are. It's just a really nice accent piece for pretty much anything.
Now, I don't know if you were watching the Cassie Brown Cake Academy show last Sunday at 5 o'clock. She was showing you how to make flowers from scratch. So there's probably two very different types of people, those that would prefer to buy them already made like this, mm-hmm. or whether you prefer to make them. You can always look back at that show as well on our website, createandcraft.tv. If you go to the Cake Academy sections there, all the shows are there to be replayed at your convenience whenever you like. But I do like the idea mm-hmm. of buying them already made.
Well, sometimes it's just a matter of budget, you know.
Yeah.
Somebody wants, you know, doesn't have a lot of money to spend, but they want a really nice cake, maybe for a baby shower or something, and they really want some flowers, then, you know, you can't really make them by hand because it takes hours to make mm-hmm. a handmade flower, usually, at least for me. Maybe I'm doing it wrong. So this is a nice little accent piece. Of course, it's not going to be as good as a handmade thing.
And you've even got the protective little bubble wrap case
yeah.
in there as well, so they arrive to you in pristine condition. So you get 12 of them. They've already been airbrushed as well a little bit, so there's a little subtle hint of pink around the outside edge. But these are, would you take these off the cake or would you eat them?
Oh, you could eat them for
right.
sure. So, they're going to be hard and crunchy like a candy,
mm-hmm.
but I'm sure kids don't mind.
No, absolutely.
It's made out of sugar. So it's always nice to have whatever you put on a cake to keep it edible.
Excellent.
So when I use these flowers, I tend to take a little bit of my sugar paste or whatever I have, and I'll just roll them into a ball and then into a teardrop shape, and I'll just make a pattern going around. And you could use green if you want, but white, pink, and baby blue is kind of vintagey colors.
Mm-hmm.
Also ivory, you know. And you just go around, and then you can take one of your modeling tools here. I have no idea if this is what this is for, but this is like one of those multi-purpose tools.
If it does what you want
yeah,
it to do.
Yeah,
then.
That's the kind of nice thing about them, is they have these different straight edges. You can go in and just make some little leaves.
Oh, cute.
And just real fast and easy. Some more of your little edible glue. And then one of your little flowers.
Mm-hmm. Is vintage a theme that you particularly love?
I do love vintage. I made a Alice in Wonderland themed vintage cake that was you know, vintage from top to bottom, and I kept that for, it was for a bridal show, and wow. I kept it for way too long. It was getting dusty and sad, but it just is so beautiful. I just love things that kind of have a history, and I think that a lot of people feel that way. Maybe it reminds them of family or grandparents or something, but it's just so pretty.
And you know, everyone's different, but if you have a vintage wedding cake or something like that, it's so elegant and sophisticated, yep. It really, really can be. And there's so much on the market and so much available as well these days that will make the vintage cakes easy and achievable. The thing is, with technology these days and the molds that are available, and we're talking cake lace a little bit later, mm-hmm. of course, yep. as well, everybody can get amazing jaw-dropping results. You really can. Mm-hmm. And it's all on the website to check out. So this is the place to arrive and to go to if you want to be a proficient cake decorator that everyone's going to really admire, and maybe even turn it into a little business if you wanted to do that as well, which lots of people I know do.
Well, you know, when I first started cake decorating, I actually would look at other cakes online, and I just thought, how do people make these cakes? And I didn't understand, you know, how they were making these amazing designs and things. And it wasn't until much later in my career that I found out that professional cake decorators used stencils and molds and all of these things, and I just thought, well, here I am doing it by hand. No wonder it doesn't look as good. So it's I wouldn't say it's a secret per se, because you know it's a lot more well known now, but
and it's very serious. I was walking through the Cake International show, and I was seeing gentlemen and ladies in white coats, mm-hmm. taking notes, mm-hmm. judging, yep. and looking at every little intricate detail, mm-hmm. and some of them, just look at these cakes here in front of us today, mm-hmm. they are amazing works of art. That's what they are. Mm-hmm.
And you'll see cake lace and molds and things on professional entries at Cake International, and they just use them really creatively. You know, you're not just taking a mold and saying, oh, well, you just took a mold and you slapped it on a cake. You integrate the mold into the overall design, so you might have some hand-painted elements on your cake, but then you incorporate a mold sure. border. So you yeah. save time where you can.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. So we've got the Ophelia cake lace mat on the screen at the moment, which mm-hmm. is $18.99, mm-hmm. 342. 620.
Yeah. Okay, and that's, more demos this now. Is the Ophelia right here.
This is it here, this
yeah,
one here.
Right. This one right here. And this is not entirely dry, but it basically the cake down there, with the black lace, that's the Ophelia design. And I have this one here with the butterfly. And this is the same types. There's like a million designs of these mats, and with endless possibilities and uses. I mean, you could just play for days and days and days. But one of the designs I really like is taking small amounts of the lace and attaching it to the cake. Mm-hmm. And so here I have the butterfly lace mat, where I've basically stitched together the different butterflies to make it look like there was a whole piece of lace draped over the cake.
Beautiful.
And so I'm gonna show you, this is the pre-made cake lace that you use. Mm-hmm. It just comes right in a container just like this. It's ready to go. You don't have to prepare it in any sort of way.
Now also, there are various different colors and different finishes as well. There's gold, there's silver, there's pearlescent white, and they come in tubs like this, so you can reseal them and keep them for a while. We'll put all the details of what we're using on the show on the screen for you. The pearlized white is on there now, or soft gold you can choose between, and it's a lovely consistency. It's difficult to describe, actually. It's not like sugar paste. It's a much softer material than that. It's more like
it's almost like plaster.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
It is.
Yeah.
It's like a very pretty pearlized plaster.
Yeah.
And the gold is great too if you want to hand paint on top of it too. To get, remember I was telling you about the fondant, it's nice to start with a dark colored fondant and then you put the gold on top to make sure it's sparkly. Same thing goes with the cake lace. You start with a dark gold color and then you can brush a little bit of the gold on top and it adds that extra oomph.
How long have you known about cake lace? Have you used it for a while?
Or? Oh yeah. I think I knew about cake lace before a lot of people knew about it. So it was a secret for a little while, and then everybody started using it. You're like, darn it, everybody knows about it, because you know you get all these accolades. It's like, wow, this is so great, this is so great. And it's like, oh, I know.
Yeah, it's your secret until the whole world starts to hear about
right,
it.
Right. Well, because the thing is when something works and it's so easy, it's bound to catch on. You know. So I mean, if you go to Cake International, the cake lace booth is just beyond packed. I mean, give yourself a 10-minute break, bring your phone, you know, and just stand in line, because it's massive. People absolutely love this stuff because it's so easy. So you just open up the container, and this butterfly mat, it has all these different shapes of butterflies on here. And what you want to do is you want to take the pre-made paste, and you push it into the mold as much as you can, because it tends to get these little bubbles stuck down in there.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to smush, 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 and then you scrape off the excess. Smush, 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 smush. Scrape off the excess. Like that. And then when you you pop this into the oven at, I think it's 70 degrees, Celsius? Oh,
yeah, it's very slow, isn't it?
Yeah, very low. Pretty much the lowest setting.
The lowest temperature.
Yeah, that your oven will go for about 10 minutes, and then it's going to firm up, and you're going to go in and put another layer on there because this has moisture in it. And right. when it goes into the oven, the moisture evaporates, and all you're left with is sort of this, you know, rubbery gelatin. I'm not sure what's in it. It's magical, mm-hmm. whatever it is.
And it's edible.
It's edible, absolutely. It tastes just like vanilla, you know? And you don't even really notice it when it goes on top of the cake. It just kind of all melts together.
And there are loads of other cake lace mats as well and cake lace products. And again, they'll be on the website too. Had a lovely email from Jean Cooper in Aylesbury. Hello, Jean. She says, hello to everyone in the studio. Just wanted to say that I'm really enjoying the Cake Academy shows. It's so useful to learn new techniques and new ideas. And it's great watching the experts in action. I love the cake lace and wonderful moulds that you sell. The moulds make cake decorating so easy. I love making cakes for friends and family. Here's a photo of a cake I made for my friend's Polly's 60th birthday. She loves pigs, so I went with that take theme. I used cake lace and the pearl mould on this one. So here it is. There it comes. Wow.
Wonderful, wow.
That's gorgeous, isn't it?
That's beautiful.
And you've also got the pearls, I think, around the base of the cakes as well that we were using earlier on in the show. So thank you for that, Jean. Lovely to know you're loving the shows. And more importantly, we're loving your cake.
Yeah, absolutely. Who doesn't love cake?
Absolutely.
So after you put the second layer of the cake lace on there and you take it out of the oven, you let it cool a little bit, and then these just pop right out of this. Super, super easy.
Look at this.
And you have these super delicate little butterflies. I got to be careful with them, though. There you go.
Well, lots of you are loving this and you're going for it on the phones and also on the website as well. And I just want to welcome anyone of you that's brand new. Also, welcome back if you're an existing Crate and Craft customer. But we're finding more and more of you are finding this kind of go-to show every Sunday at 5 o'clock. It's the perfect time and it's the perfect day, really, isn't it, to sit back, have a cup of tea or something and watch maybe a new hobby take shape or lots of tips and techniques from experts like Liz here today. It's every Sunday at 5 o'clock. Series link it on Sky or Virgin. You've got that option, of course, as well. But remember, we will be bringing more and more cake decorating techniques and tips and products as it grows in popularity, and that's what's happening right here today. Mm-hmm. And look at the cake lace butterflies that have come off this mat. They are absolutely beautiful. Mm-hmm. The detail is phenomenal. Mm-hmm. You can see why the cake lace stand at the NEC is absolutely rammed, and you can just order it today. Mm-hmm. No queuing. Mm-hmm. No hassle, no fuss.
Yeah, that's the great thing about ordering online. You can do it in pajamas.
Yeah, and you have to be on your feet for 8 hours.
Yeah. It is intense. So you can attach this to the cake with just a little bit of water and a nice brush. Mm-hmm. Just give it a little swipe. And basically what I'm doing is I'm trying to make the cake tacky, not necessarily wet. So you don't want to really go nuts with the water. I'm kind of just smushing it over.
So just a little bit of water.
Take one of your little delicate butterflies. Come here, little butterfly. And then right side up here.
So you can put them flat or you can actually make them three-dimensional. So they look as if they're just landing on the cake, don't they, then?
Yes. So you just press that on there. Stick.
It's so easy to do.
Yeah.
When you've got the right products and right tools.
Yeah, and then you can continue to build it up and you can bend it over the edges and attach them together and create, look, because, you know, if you had a flat piece of cake lace and you draped it over the top, it'd end up getting ripples and things like that. So when you use the individual pieces and you sort of wrap it around the cake, you don't have any ripples.
Okay, with your expert hat on then, someone watching today who's wanted to decorate cakes but has never really tried it, what are the first few things that everyone needs to invest in? What should a cake decorator invest in first?
I think, good pans is one of them. We don't have any here, but that's really important. A few molds that you really like. Whenever you're decorating, you're going to be drawn to things that you just personally like, and that's kind of how you develop your own style as well. So don't worry about what you think everybody else is going to love. Just say, you know, I really like vintage looks. I really like vintage cakes designs, and your passion is going to come through with those things. So if you buy things that all sort of go together, it's like a wardrobe. If you like dark colored clothes, you buy a dark shirt and dark shoes and not neon socks. And that way everything always goes together. So when you're investing in these tools, you'll always be able to go back and use them.
And of course, the tools from Wilton that are in the show as well. Once you've got those, you don't need to buy them again ever, really. They're going to last you a lifetime. And we'll put the details of those tools up on the screen as well, the 10-piece kit. And there's Liz in action with some of her amazing cakes. And you've made cakes for the rich and the famous. And you can tell it's a passion. And just everything that you've done on all the cakes that we've just been showing you there, amazing results, amazing designs. And then how long have you been doing it for?
I've been doing it for coming up on 8 years now.
All right.
Yeah, and that sounds like a really long time because I'm kind of an artistic personality, and so I don't really tend to stick to things for very long and kind of flit from one interest to another. But cake decorating is one of those things that you never run out of things to learn. There's always new techniques coming out. There's always new tools. And it just is always an interesting thing to be doing, and people just love it, so it's hard to stop.
Well, look at these. These are literally edible works of art.
That one with all of the gold in the center, that was almost all molds up and down that middle tier. Yeah. Otherwise, I would have never got that done.
Was it one of the ones there, Moby Dick? Was it the whale?
Yeah, that was for another competition, and it had...
Look at that.
Yeah, that was all handmade, so that took quite a long time.
Well, if you want to go for the Wilton 10-piece set, it's on the screen right now. The tools that you'll need, you only need to buy them once. Once you've got them, you've got them. And it's £32.39 if you're in the Create and Craft Club. Now, the cake lace moulds, let's remind you of those then. The butterflies that we've just been using with Liz here today. And you've actually got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. There's the best part of about 20 different butterflies and dragonflies on this mould as well. You don't need to put the cake lace in every single one if you don't want to. You can just make one or two in the oven for 70 degrees for about 10 minutes. And then put a little bit more on, back more into the oven, and then it's ready to go. So it doesn't take long to do at all.
Nope. And, you know, you can use this cake lace on its own as the main focal point, or you can use it as a base and add piping and detailing over the top of it, which is what I'm going to do. And I'm using the piping tips here. This is a great set of piping tips that you can get from Wilton as well.
Right.
And it comes with every type of piping tip that you could possibly ever need in your entire career, unless you do something really, really specific. But, you know, you got the different kind of leaves, the grass, borders, pearls, all different sizes and everything, and they're real high quality.
Now, again, these nozzles are actually on the website as well. As I mentioned at the beginning of the show, we're really proud of the association we've got with Wilton as well. Wilton are an American brand, and they supply lots of places here in the UK, but only a few places carry Wilton products, and none of them carry the whole collection of Wilton products that's available, except us. We do at Create and Craft, and we've got a lovely relationship with them. So whenever you want anything Wilton, just go to the Create and Craft website, createandcraft.tv, the Cake Academy section just there, or go to createandcraft.tv/Cake Academy, and that will take you to the Cake Academy page, and you'll see the Wilton shop there as well. Everything Wilton produce is available through us, including these fantastic nozzles.
That's right. And this is actually just a piping bag with one of the couplers. This comes in the kit, and this basically, what this allows me to do is switch out my tips whenever I want to. So I could start doing some ruffles and then say, oh, now I want to do a purl. You just take off the coupler, unscrew like this, which I didn't know about when I first started cake decorating. And when I saw somebody do this, I went, you've got to be kidding me. And then you can add on a different tip and screw that on.
Oh, great idea.
Yeah.
So this is completely reusable rather than lots of disposable ones.
Absolutely, yeah. You know, and nothing wrong with disposable, but if you wanted to invest in a nice piping bag, you can definitely do that.
And is that a Wilton bag as well?
You know, I'm not for sure. I don't think so.
Okay.
They make really nice reusable bags as well as disposable, though.
Okay. And they're on the website, too.
And so I'm going to just... do my best to pipe. I told you I'm not a piper, right? But I would do my best here to pipe.
Something tells me you're going to make a good job of it.
Well, normally we have it on a turntable as well, and it's also not on camera, you know. But anyways, you just start with the pointy side against the cake here. And you just take your time. And basically the tip does the work because of the way that it's, made.
Oh, it's like a lovely frill around the edge.
It just makes this nice little frill just all on its own. Now, it's quite hot in here, so I'm not sure how long this royal icing will hold up.
Mm-hmm.
But you get the idea when you're using buttercream and stuff.
What's the best sort of conditions to work in to pipe in like this? Cool room?
Or? Yeah, you really want your room to be fairly cool.
Right.
Preferably not in front of cameras and lights.
Yes.
But, you know, you want your room to be cool. So if you have sort of a hot environment, you want to turn on at least a fan, like even a box fan to get the air moving in the room will help immensely. But you can see now, so what we're kind of creating is sort of a dress effect.
Right.
So you have lace down at the bottom, you have your pearls, and now we're adding some ruffles around the top.
It's refreshing to see, actually, you're using lots of different techniques, because we've used lots of different brands. We've had, of course, obviously, cake lace. We talked about the Katie Sue mould for the pearls down the bottom there. And now we're using, of course, the Wilton Tips and Karen Davis. So don't think, because I'm using cake lace, I've got to make an entire cake out of cake lace moulds. No, they all work together.
Absolutely.
You can put your own twist on it.
And that's why you kind of, when you want to, you want to purchase tools that you can kind of use for everything. So like the modeling tools, the piping tips, you can use those. You'll use those every day. Use them all the time. Wilton also makes a really great rolling pin. That I use all of the time. And then
is that the white resin one?
Yeah, it's wonderful. And so then, so those are tools that you use every day. But then you also want to make little sets of themes. So if somebody says, "I want a vintage cake," well, you're like, "Well, I have one bow." You know, but you don't really have much of anything else. So you say, okay, I got a bow, I got a brooch, I got a pearl. You could make a million different designs with those three things.
Using different colorings.
Yep, different colorings, different configurations. And I find, honestly, that if you have every mold underneath the sun, you're almost overwhelmed with options. But if you limit yourself to a few, you know, key items, each under a theme, so you might want to do some fashion molds and then some vintage molds, but just two or three, then your creativity really comes through.
Sure. Brilliant.
So I'm just going to do one more here.
So how long are you in the UK for now?
I'm actually heading over to London tomorrow, my first time. Yeah, I can't wait. I hear it's beautiful. I mean, people wouldn't go to London if it was terrible.
It's a great place.
And the weather is actually wonderful here.
Really?
It's almost exactly the same as Oregon.
Okay.
Yeah, it's always
that's where you're from.
Yeah. Okay. A little overcast and rainy, but you know, not too chilly.
Not too cold.
Not too chilly.
You'll love London.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Okay, well, there's another great technique. Remember, we're using the Wilton piping heads here, the piping nozzles, as you can see here. There are lots and lots and lots of them. They are, of course, on the Wilton section of our website as well. There's a whole Wilton section there, and there's an organizer tray that they come in as well with a purple lid too. Just go to www.crankcraft.tv/cakeacademy. You'll find everything there, and you'll find all the different stores we have included in that, which, of course, includes Wilton too. So if you would like to go for the cake lace mat that we've been talking about, that's the full one with the butterflies. That's 309484. And we've also got the beautiful wrap as well, the wrap mat that we showed you a few minutes ago. Let's remind you, though, of what we've been using just in the last few minutes. There is your butterflies and dragonflies. So £32.99 if you're not in the club. If you are, it's £29.69, 309484. And also the wrap I was talking about, which is the Ophelia wrap. Here it comes. There it is, and that is £17.09, or £18.99 if you're not in the Crate and Craft Club. Join it before you buy anything, because you save money, and you'll save money every single week if you're a regular viewer to the Cake Academy as well. We'll give you a demo and show you the Ophelia in a second. Now, we've also got the Art Nouveau. This is also from Cake Lace as well. I don't know if we can see the pattern in close-up. There it is. Look, great. And that's 37 centimetres by 8 centimetres in width. And that's £17.09. So all of these, remember, you use the Cake Lace product, which comes in various different colours, a silver, a gold, a cream, as well a pearl. And here's the white option for you. The 200 grams of white cake lace is £8.09, if you'd like that. And it's all pre-mixed for you. And there are different colours, of course, as well. So you can choose all sorts of different colours. Gold, silver, white, pearl. There's all sorts to choose from. Now, this is the choice of colours. Either the pearlized white or the soft gold. The one you showed you a few seconds ago is just the plain white one. This is the pearlized white or soft gold. The soft gold is absolutely opulent. It really does look incredible. 320-309. Now, the Ophelia as well, let's just quickly remind you of that one. This is probably one of the most ornate mats I've seen. And whether you use it going up or going down, I mean, this cake has been finished with it here, and it's almost like chandeliers all the way around the cake, isn't it?
It's one of their most popular designs. I feel like everybody I know who uses cake lace has this one. So if you feel like maybe the lace mats are too much of an investment and you want to just start out small, I definitely recommend getting this one. You can use it for a whole bunch of different designs, different colors. This is a real... you know, wow kind of effect with the black and the white. But you can tone it down by doing white on pink.
To be honest with you wouldn't need much on there apart from that.
No, I mean, this is one of those things that you can really just put on the cake all by itself and it just looks spectacular. And people who don't know who cake lace is, usually your customers and clients, mm-hmm. they just think amazing. But this, you know, aside from covering in the sugar paste, probably took, you know, 10 minutes.
Absolutely. And yeah. it's done. And it really is incredibly dramatic and beautiful. Imagine that done in the gold as well. We mm-hmm. talked about the gold cake lace a minute ago. That would look incredible. Mm-hmm. Now, do bear in mind, remember, this is something that we do every single, this is only the fourth episode of Cake Academy. Previously, we've had the fantastic Cassie Brown, Christina Ludlam's been here as well, Rosie Cake Diva too. They were all at the Cake International over the last few days. And we're going to be having more and more fantastic expert guests in the weeks to come. If there's anything you want to see as well, in particular, a technique or something like that, always email in and we can suggest it to the powers that be, studio@createandcraft.tv. And again, any questions, we'd like to hear from you too. But do remember, series recording is the way to make sure that every single week you don't miss the show. Obviously, Sunday at 5 o'clock, sometimes people have got things to do with the family and so on, so you can't always be watching the TV. Series link it on Sky. We've just heard that you can series link it on Virgin as well, which you didn't realise until today. So, yeah, it will automatically record every Cake Lace show for you, and also any other Cake Academy show, or indeed any other Cake Academy related show will be recorded as well for your pleasure in the weeks and months to come. Okay, now go to the website, createandcraft.tv, and you'll see everything. We've got the Cake Masters magazines, remember, the back issues, 3 back issues for just £5, that's there. And all the things that we've been showing you during the hour as well from Liz. It's all at literally the click of a mouse, touch of a button, including the Renshaw paste, the moulds. And again, as we said earlier on, don't think of the moulds as being a cheat. The professionals use the moulds as well.
Absolutely.
It's just how you use them and interpret them, isn't it, really?
Yeah, oh, really. I mean, you could take something like these bow moulds, and you can use an accent and put it around every single one of these little things and just bring it to the next level. Mm. You could take some of this piping and do a little ruffle around the top and then the bows in the center. You could use the roses. You could use the jarges and take it to, you know, as complicated as you want to make it. But, you know, to just sit there and make a little bow, especially if you need 100 of them, you know, mm. this is going to take you a long time. And honestly, professionals, if you are in the business of making an income, you know, that's a professional, mm-hmm. then you want to be doing things that save you time, because the time is money, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah?
And you want to get professional results. Everybody does. Cakes like this, that are decorated like this, if you actually commission them, can cost you hundreds and hundreds of pounds. I'm sure you know that. So to make them yourself, get a blank cake and then decorate it yourself, or make the cake from scratch even better, that's what these shows are all about. Now, just a quick reminder about the back issues from Cake Masters, who in association with Create and Craft bring us these shows. They're normally £3.70 an issue, so if you want to go for the 3 back issues, it doesn't really matter what time of the year they came out. Lots of tips and inspiration in there, and it's Liz's favourite magazine.
And there's great tutorials in there too. Really, really great tutorials.
Brilliant. 3 for £5. Mm-hmm. So they're on the show as well if you'd like to mm-hmm. order yours today. Mm-hmm. Nearly out of time. Remember, we've got the lovely Karen Davis coming in next week, mm-hmm. and we've been using her moulds in the show. I dare say we'll be using mm-hmm. more moulds next Sunday mm-hmm. at 5 o'clock. Liz, enjoy London.
Thank you so much. It was great being here.
It's great having you here as well. And congratulations on the award as well.
Thank you. Okay, you're going to ship it home for me? It weighs about 10 pounds.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Is it a trophy or something?
It's like glass. It's solid glass. And they handed it to me and I went, oh!
Fantastic. Brilliant. Yeah. I'll see you again, hopefully.
Yeah, I hope so.
Thank you for watching episode 4 of the Cake Academy then. And thank you to Cake Masters too for the back issues. And here's more about them. See you soon.
Cake Masters magazine is one of the UK's leading cake decorating monthlies. It includes fabulous step-by-step cake tutorials, recipes, expert advice, competitions, interviews, design inspirations, and so much more. You can order your 12-month subscription to Cake Masters magazine right here for just £35, and with 3 UK...